This bandsaw-on-a-dolly idea works for milling logs, but it wasn't perfect. My sawhorses were a little bit wobbly, so I added some screws to make them more rigid. And the bandsaw is underpowered, and I also had difficulty rolling it smoothly with the small wheels on the dolly, and it also rocks back and forth a little bit, which made it hard to move it smoothly. I've got a bunch of short logs that I want to mill up, but before I do that, I want to improve this saw by putting it on a more dedicated dolly. And as soon as I put that on there, I realized I didn't actually leave any room to actually operate this latch here. So I had to cut that out. This piece of plywood attaches with this screw, which would normally hold this cover here, and that holds the saw and prevents it from tipping back and forth so that I can push it more evenly without having it wobble on the top. It's still way underpowered, but I'm running out of time for today and I just want to try it out. I'm manually applying a little bit of soap to the blade because I'm getting buildup on it. With the new dolly, I can feed the saw slowly, much smoother, and with that, the 3/4 horsepower seems adequate. I'm having more issues with vibrations than I did last time, and I think it's mostly because this log is a lot smaller and a lot lighter. I just released my first video on using this bandsaw as a sawmill, and I guess I should have mentioned that the idea of putting this thing on tracks had occurred to me, but I decided not to do it. Instead, I just put it on bigger casters, and those, for the most part, solved the problem. Much simpler this way, and that way I can move the bandsaw out of the way. But a bigger problem I'm running into now is vibrations, and I think it's because with this additional board there, this is just sticking out too far, so I have a little bit of flex there. So I made some newer supports to go on here out of solid hardwood, and these will be shorter. Got the new supports mounted. I put the 2x4 for a guide vertically, which brought the saw in closer and actually had to notch out part of the sawhorse. So hopefully that'll fix the vibration issues. Even if I could capture all the sawdust from the bandsaw, there's still bits of bark that fall off just as I'm cutting, and I wouldn't be able to capture those from below. So, not perfect, but the bigger rollers help a lot. A shortcoming of the setup is that it's very time-consuming to reposition the log between cuts. That part actually takes more time than the cutting itself. Well, that's what came out of this one. Matt Cremona keeps getting excited about crotch figure, but for myself, I'd rather just cut out the defective parts than to mess around with dovetail keys and epoxy. My log mounting system is less than ideal because in order to get a good support here, I always have to make the first cut on the log to be able to rest it properly, and that means I couldn't get all the way to the edge on either side, and then as I cut away boards from this log, I no longer have enough support to make sure that it's vertical like this, so I always have to prop it to keep it from tipping over, especially as I get towards the end, at which point I have to flip the log over. And then it gets really time consuming to always support it. So a possible future improvement would be some kind of log clamping bracket like this. And that way I could keep sliding the log forward and take slices off of it without having to rotate the log or actually flatten one of the edges. But I don't know how good this would be in terms of vibrations. But if the goal is to cut slabs, I think a horizontal mill would make a lot more sense, because that way you can just cut through the entire log until you get almost down to the supports, and then just flip over what's left to kind of finish it off.